And then and only then did they leave. Now, let's do a 40-year walkabout through the desert. And now we find ourselves at the bank of a different body of water, this time the Jordan River. Now the promised land is in sight. And God has asked one simple thing. Priests, pick up the ark and lead the people across the water and go get your land. Simple. But you have to remember that these were Levitical priests. These were the men that had been set aside by God as the holiest of the Jewish people. They had gone through ritual cleaning, and they'd been anointed with oil. They were in their finest robes, the white ones with the gold, like we see in the pictures, and they were decked out. And they were carrying about half a ton of gold on their shoulders. So Joshua 3 picks up the story and tells us what happens next. So the people left the place where they had camped and followed the priests who carried the Ark of the Agreement across the Jordan River. During the harvest, the Jordan overflows its banks. When the priests carrying the ark came to the edge of the river and stepped onto the water, the waters upstream stopped flowing. Now, I really want to stress, did you catch that? Their faith and their trust had grown so much that this time they didn't see obstacles. They didn't hear bad news. They saw the promise and were willing to get their feet wet. And going off script one more time, because this was something I just learned was told today. Back in Exodus, it says that the Lord parted the waters to show dry ground. It does not say that in Joshua. It talks about a muddy river that is overflowing its banks and that the Lord stopped the flow of the water, which says to me that they were still walking in their finery and carrying that heavy load in some water and some muck and was probably getting squishy mud between their toes. But that's okay. They didn't see the muck. They saw the promise. And see, it's that with that kind of faith that I can tell you that I am healed. I am healed emotionally, mentally, spiritually, in my relationships, and yes, even physically. And you can be too. And I understand it's a big step, but I'm asking you tonight, are you willing to get your feet wet? Are you willing to step through that muck? Because God uses others to heal us. And we're going to go into a time of just some table talk. And I'm just asking you, step out in faith. Let these sisters that you have around you pray for you. Let God work through them to heal you. And I want to leave you with this final thought. It's from Psalms 37. He says, "The Lord directs the steps of the godly. He delights in every aspect of their lives. Though they stumble, they will not fall. For the Lord holds them by the hand." Can you picture that? As you're stepping into that water, the Lord is holding you by the hand.